皆さん音楽は好きですか？私は大好き。ザ・ウィーケンドがあなたのためにいっぱい曲を作ったみたいだよ。楽しみだね。ザ・ウィーケンドの曲を聴くといっぱいハッピーになれるよ。その秘密を知りたい？私が今から教えてあげる。もしみんなもハッピーになりたかったら今すぐここに電話。番号は647-794-9223。 みんなも今すぐ電話して一緒にハッピーになろう。はい、今超ハッピー。ザ・ウィーケンドのアルバムが9月10日に発売だって。9月10日はハッピーの日に間違いなし。超楽しみ。
ぜひお試しを。647-794-9223。 楽しい時間が待ってます。647-794-9223。 今すぐ連絡を。
Yeah, you see that date? You see it? 10 o'clock in the morning. In the morning! About to listen to fucking Kiss Man for the fucking first time! After all of that fucking peer pressure, man! After all of the time waiting for this motherfucker to drop. I didn't give in! Even with permission from the man himself. The body was willing, bitch. But the mind was set.
It's time. Yeah, it's freaking time, yo. I cannot put this video off any freaking longer, and it's my birthday. The legend of Kissland is finally here. Now, 2013 was such a different time for EXO. We were just coming off of the freaking, I don't even know what you would call it, the freaking explosion from Trilogy. And so many people were trying to figure out, you know, when is the Weeknd dropping something new? What are we in for when it comes to the Weeknd's career and everything like that? 2013 hit and Kissland was announced, yo. When I found out Kissland was coming out, I almost died. I'm not even gonna freaking lie to y'all. I'm sitting in my freaking room like, yo, this album about to drop and it's about to be freaking amazing. And damn it, it was freaking amazing. Okay, now I was looking at some reviews on Kissland, you know, when it dropped and everything, and I can honestly see why The Weeknd does not perform any Kissland songs at his shows, because the backlash that drink got is absolutely ridiculous. Okay, The Weeknd drops Kissland and EXO crew loved it. So many other people outside of EXO crew love that joint. But when you look at freaking reviews, people talking about, oh, you're better off listening to the 3 mixtapes that came before this. It's just like, what? Huh? Kissland is such a freaking work of art and a daggone masterpiece in itself that it pains me so much that everyone talks about Starboy, everyone talks about Beauty Behind the Madness, everyone talks about Trilogy, but kicks Kissland off to the curb, acts like Kissland never dropped, acts like Kissland never came out, acts like Kissland isn't the better project out of both Beauty Behind the Madness and Starboy. Now in today's video, I'm gonna bring y'all back. Oh, we going back to 2013. We going back to the time. Oh man, I can't. To start this off, we're gonna talk about the visuals. Oh, roll the freaking visuals, bro.
Somebody told me it was pointless for me to come back into your arms. Said you found another man finally. I knew this day would come. Oh, as long as you know that when I land your mind, and you will never feel so pretty, and you will never feel this beautiful when I make it there.
the visuals for freaking pretty. Now, do you honestly, if you're sitting there and you're not a member of EXO, I mean, if you're not a fan of The Weeknd or whatever, let me ask you a freaking question. Are you retarded? Let me just ask you that. You seeing that daggone visual for that freaking song, right? You're listening to the lyrics, bro, and it's just like, what are you doing? How do you not like this? How do you not enjoy this? How are you sitting there saying to yourself, I don't really like it. I would much rather listen to Katy Perry. Like, come on, son. When I first listened to Pretty, legit, I almost cried. Like, I'm not even gonna lie to you. I started thinking about this girl that I know for a fact was talking to other guys, banging other guys, while I was just trying to take out on a date to BBQs, you feel me? And I would listen to the song, and honestly, some days I would listen to it, and I'd be thinking, yo, son, I should just pull up to a house right now with the 12 gay shoddy and blow everybody away and, you know, do my best in jail, because honestly, son, that's how the song made me feel, yo. And if the girl I'm talking about is watching this, why you do me like that, son? Now, as we continue with The Legend of Kissland, I will also be talking about the other visuals from this era, like the music video for Belong to the World. The music video for Kissland.
Probably not if I keep my habits up. Probably not if I can't keep up with love. And I can't stand talking to brand new girls. Only bitches down to fuck when you share with them the ones.
The music video for Love in the Sky.
And even if I try, it's not something I would know. But I'm sure I'll make you come, do it three times in a row. And I'm sure you would have left, but that pussy in control. Got that pussy in control, I got it in control.
I don't think y'all understand, when these visuals dropped, bro, it made me even more hype for this album. It made me even more excited because oh my gosh, bro, it's just like, it doesn't make any sense. Like, 2013 of EXO was such an amazing ass year, bro. The visuals, the instrumentals, the transitions, the freaking commercial one, you know, next let's talk about the freaking instrumentals on this daggone album known as Kissland. Now, I don't know if y'all can hear in the back, but I already got the pretty instrumental chilling in the background. But one of the instrumentals, one of the transitions that I would like to talk about is the transition from Adaptation to Love in the Sky. Now, if you thought The Weeknd was just a boring ass R&B singer, somebody who ain't shit, somebody who's just a regular ass R&B dude who talks about girls, and just shut up, take all that and shove it up your ass, because the transition from Adaptation to Love in the Sky is possibly one of the greatest things I've ever heard in my freaking life. We go from adapted to these models, who's adapted to the bottle, she take it down like water just to burn away these sorrows, and all is fair in loving while she's pure, so pure. We go from that to how does it feel? Do you feel like you did before? Do you see the world getting small? How does it feel? Are you kidding me? That whole transition is sex, son. It's sex to my ears, bro. If you thought that transition was freaking amazing, Do I even need to talk about the transition on Kissland? Do I need to talk about it? Talk about it, bro. Nah. We gonna talk about it. Chill out. The transition on Kissland is also the second greatest thing I've ever heard in my life. We went from... Yo. I'm telling you right now, the first time I heard the daggone transition on freaking Kissland, I legit called my friend up and I was like, bro, do you have any drugs? Mind you, I don't do freaking drugs, okay? I don't even drink, all right? The most I'm drinking is freaking water, okay? And I called my bro, I said, yo, bro, you got any freaking, you know where I could get cocaine? He's like, cocaine? What? I said, listen, I'm listening to freaking Kissland right now, and I feel like going out to a club and snorting an entire bag of cocaine. Do you have any? And he was like, I could see what I could do, but he never got it for me because he was talking about, oh, you can overdose and all. I'm trying to overdose. You feel me? I'm trying to overdose with some kids laying in the background. Y'all playing with me, son. Anyway. Kissland was such an amazing work of art, bro. And not only the visuals from the music videos, not only the transitions on this album that really hit home for me, it was the freaking lyrics, okay? The lyrics, son. So you're somebody now, but what's a somebody in a nobody town? I don't think you even know it. Oh my. What does it mean? When your heart's already numb, your professional won't treat it like it's personal. No, cause it's just love. Sing with me. It always makes its way back around. It's dispensable. To fall is unacceptable. Cause everything you've been through made you stronger. Doom, doom, doom. And everything you learned about yourself. Doom, doom, doom. And oh my God! Man, oh man. What happened, Weekend? What happened, Abel? What happened, bro? We went from Trilogy to Kissland. Just to wait 2 years later for Beauty Behind the Madness. Like, I get it. If you want to compare Beauty Behind the Madness to Starboy, Beauty Behind the Madness is much darker than Starboy. I totally get it. But legit, we waited 2 years, bro. 2 years later for Beauty Behind the Madness after such an amazing body of work known as Kissland. And the thing that also is, like, bugging me out is the fact that so many people, when Beauty Behind the Madness came out, you had all these other celebrities talking about how they've been fans of The Weeknd and all this other stuff. Just because he was on tracks like Earned It, Where You Belong, The Hills, Can't Feel My Face. You know, it's just stuff like that. And I'm just sitting back like, yo, where was y'all in 2013 when freaking Kissland dropped, bro? Another thing that I would like to show you guys, the live performances in 2013. I was broke back then. I'm gonna let y'all know right now. 2013, I was broke. I had no money for freaking tours. I had no freaking money for merchandise. Okay, I'm gonna put that out right there. All right, this year I'm going to see Abel. I'm seeing him. I saw him the first time at. Fun fact, by the way, the first time I saw The Weeknd was 2014, September 9th, I believe. 2014. It was for the King of the Fall tour. And that was my first concert ever. It was The Weeknd, Janae Aiko, and Schoolboy Q. One of the best freaking... the best freaking concert I've ever gone to. You feel me? We had Janae performing first, then Schoolboy Q, then Abel finished it off. And he was performing songs from Kissland. He was performing songs from Trilogy. You feel me? He was performing... King of the Fall, like, I'm add it up, I just ate a plate for breakfast, put it in a cup, then I mix it up with Texas, chest feeling heavy like let me not spaz out on y'all, but yeah, man, I'm gonna show y'all some clips of, like, some live performances.
You can't be sure, and I'm always behind.
just like, one thing I can say about The Weeknd is that as each year, you know, each year we get something new from Abel, whether it's a new album, whether it's a new tour, whether it's a new anything, you feel me? It just gets better. Because if you compare The Weeknd from his first performance, Coachella, right? Everybody was like, yo, who's The Weeknd? You know, what The Weeknd look like? Is he a transvestite? You know, stuff like that. You feel me? You go from Coachella in, what was it, 2012, I believe? And you fast forward to 2017, and he is so freaking confident in his live performances, his live shows, his music, you know, as a whole. He's just more confident, and I love that, you feel me? But honestly, it really does pain me. It pains me to see, like, I don't know, man. I honestly hope that there is a part two to Kissland, because we need another work of art like that, because Kissland is such a freaking work of art, bro. I'm not even gonna lie to y'all. It's a work of art, and it's amazing. If you guys have not listened to Kissland, I should shoot you in your freaking toes, honestly. But go ahead. If you've never listened to the album Kissland, listen to that bitch. I'm actually gonna put a link to Kissland in the description, so y'all could go and listen to it on Apple Music, alright? I'll probably do it on Spotify too, but I don't got Spotify because I don't talk to broke bitches. Anyways, to conclude this video, man, shout out EXO, shout out The Weeknd, shout out everybody who's been there from the beginning until now. Shout out to everybody who acknowledges the fact that Kissland is alive and Kissland matters, okay? Shout out to all of y'all. I had some people that I wanted to be a part of the video, but they couldn't be a part of it. But still, shout out to y'all. I love y'all. Shout out, just shout out everybody, yo. Shout out EXO. Shout out The Weeknd. Shout out to where EXO is now as compared to where it was in the beginning, you feel me? Shout out to all of y'all. Shout out Kissland. And that's gonna be it for this video, man. If you guys enjoyed, thank you so much for freaking watching. I was really, really hyped to make this video, and I don't care how long it goes on for. Y'all might not watch it. I really don't give a damn. So this is just how I feel about this freaking album and everything that came along with it. So without further ado, if you guys enjoyed today's video, do make sure to leave a like. Don't forget to subscribe for more. As always, join the squad, and I will catch you in the next one. Shout out EXO. Shout out Kissland. I'm about to go listen to this album again for the 50 millionth time on my birthday. Who got the cocaine, bitches?
I feel like my fans will love Kissland because I didn't change. It's the same character, but in different settings and scenarios. Once you change who you are or who you've portrayed in your music, the fans, they'll catch it. Once you try to convince yourself that the fans are stupid, then you lose. You belong to them, not the other way around.